मेरी आवाज़ व्यूअर्स, टुडे वी हैव वैशाली दास विद अस. शी इज़ अ बीएमएस ग्रेजुएट, अ फ्रेशर एंड रिसेंटली कंप्लीटेड हर एमबीए फ्रॉम डीवाई पाटिल पुणे. टुडे शी विल बी शेयरिंग हर स्कोप विद ऑल ऑफ अस. सो हाय वैशाली, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन सर, हाउ अबाउट यू?
आई एम डूइंग गुड. सो वैशाली, कैन यू ब्रीफ आवर व्यूअर्स अबाउट योर प्रोफाइल?
Okay, so basically I have completed my PGDM from D.Y. Patil B School, Pune, and my specialization was marketing. So, our college offers a complete, a core specialization. Like many other colleges, they offer dual specialization. But in our college, it's not the case. We have one single core specialization. So my specialization was marketing. And before that also in BBA, I have also my specialization over there was marketing and HR as well.
Okay, great. So Ranchi to Pune, you did your graduation in Ranchi and now you are in Pune. So how was the journey and were you able to cope up with the cultural change?
For a girl, for living in a small town like Ranchi, it is a dream for them to go out and for higher studies. And, the growth opportunities, as we hear sitting in Ranchi, if you hear about the growth opportunities in Ranchi, it is very limited. And otherwise, if you go to cities like Pune, Mumbai, Delhi, there are many opportunities. So everyone wants to go out for studies. I was one of those girls who wanted to go out for studies. Luckily, my brother, my partial family, who lives in Pune. So he asked me to come to Pune. There are many colleges and I can try in one of it for MBA. So I heard about D.Y. Patil B School and I had applied in other colleges also. But this was the one I chose for my admission. So Ranchi to Pune, it was very difficult because from the very beginning I was living with my family and then all of a sudden you go to a new place, new city, new people where you don't have a lot of friends. So firstly, it was a lot of, difficult for me. But gradually when I made friends, I came to know that many of them are from outside only. There were very few people who were localite of Pune, and otherwise most of them were from UP, MP and all other parts of India. So it is like a mini India in itself in our college where all people are from other cities. So you have different cultures, different festivals. So in our college, we all used to celebrate everything of that. Like Durga Puja from Kolkata, Maharashtra, and Ganpati Visarjan from Maharashtra. We all celebrated every festival together. So the college environment made me feel like home and it wasn't at all difficult for me to adjust in Pune.
Oh, great. So, talking about the college, D.Y. Patil University, and there are many students who might be opting for this college. So, can you brief about the college insights which only a student would be knowing about?
Okay, sir. So, firstly, I would like to tell the viewers about our college, that is D.Y. Patil B School. Firstly, I would say that there are many D.Y. Patil colleges in Pune, which offers MBA program. Like other different campuses. So with the similar name, people get confused. I particularly being the student of D.Y. Patil B School, Pune, which offers full-time PGDM of 2 years. There are two courses, PGDM and PGDM plus prime. I was a student of PGDM. So being a student of PGDM, this B School offers, which is different from others is, this college basically focuses on practical exposure to the industry. Because if you are an MBA student, there is, if you are learning theoretically, you will not learn that much. If you are practically sent into an office or if you are given those work, you will be able to understand those things more practically when you are personally experiencing it. So this college mostly focuses on giving a practical exposure to the industry. As this, it offers you internship. First the winter internship and second one is the summer internship. And apart from that, if you wish to work with any firm or any company, you can get the permission from the college and you can work over there, like taking the permission from the college. So what happens to you after doing internship is you learn more about the industry and your practical experiences about working in a corporate, you learn it. Being a fresher, it is very difficult for a fresher to get a job in the market if you go out. And if you have an internship experience, it is much easier for you because you yourself have experienced it. So first thing is the internship opportunity that this college offers. And secondly is this college allows you to do certifications. There are a lot of certifications which are useful for, like I being a marketing student, there are certifications which can be helpful for me. So the college gets it done from their side only. Like there is digital marketing, there is a business analytics, which we get the certifications from IBM. So there are many certifications which the college helps us to do, and otherwise few people go for the certifications from outside. So that's one thing that you get all of it in your B school itself, which is very helpful. And third thing is multiple placement opportunities. Like many B schools, they offer single placements, and our college offers multiple placement opportunities, that is more than one. So you are given a chance at the time. Finally, it only comes up to the placement if you are doing a master's degree, basically MBA. So when you have two options, it is much easier for you to compare in between both those companies, and you can choose for yourself that which job is more suitable for you and which is giving you you are comfortable doing which job. So that these are the three basic things which I feel about my college is very good for a student, for a fresher like me.
Oh, nice. Now, if suppose I am interested in going and doing a PGDM course from D.Y. Patil University, so yes. Can you brief the viewers the selection process, like which entrance has to be appeared and the GDPR process, and how was your experience for the entire process?
So this college, the entrance exam, talking about the entrance exam, so we have the national entrance exams like CAT, ZAT, CMAT, MAT, and CET. So the scores of all these exams are accepted in this B school. I was a student of BBA. I did not get much time to prepare, like take a coaching and prepare, focusing on the CAT examinations. Everyone wants to, you know, crack CAT, but it was very difficult for me because I did not have time. I appeared for CAT in November and I did not score that much good percentile in CAT. So my friend suggested me that it is not worth it to waste a single year focusing on the CAT examination. 1 year is a big span of time. So if I focusing on CAT if after 1 year I'm not able to get good marks in CAT, then again it will be a waste of time for me. So I decided not to waste one more year and I started appearing for other examinations. So I appeared for CMAT. And luckily, I got good score in CMAT. And with this score of CMAT, I applied in D.Y. Patil B school. And seeing my score and educational background of 10th, 12th and graduation, I was called for GDNPI, which happened in Kolkata. In Ranchi, they did not center that time. So the nearest location was Kolkata, where I had to go to appear for the group discussion and personal interview round. So I went to Kolkata. And on the given date, and there were approx 50 to 60 students on that particular date. They had few different slots also. So on that day, there were 50 to 60 students and from different colleges from West Bengal and from Ranchi, somewhere from more different cities. And firstly, they briefed us about the college. What are the specialties about the college, the course, and the previous year placements and all that. They briefed us about that. And after that, our group discussion. So we were segregated into a group of 8 people, and we were given a topic to discuss. And so everyone had to put their view on that particular topic. And on the basis of their points they were putting and the communication skills and the way you were addressing the team members and the way you had team leading quality that shows, that basically appears in group discussion. So on the basis of that, few people out of those 8 people, I guess six of us were selected, and we were called for the next round, that was personal interview. So in the personal interview, there were 2 panel members from our college itself, and we were asked about our previous education, like graduation and the projects which we have done, and the internships previously which we did at the time of graduation, and then what are our interests, hobbies, why we want to go for MBA, and also which stream we want to select and why do we think that that particular stream is suitable for us. So at that time I was very confused between marketing and HR, because in BBA I had both, like my BBA college offered 2 dual specialization, so I had marketing also and I had HR also, and I was very confused that which one I have to take, either to go for marketing or to go for HR. So that was a very difficult thing for me to select one, because this college offered only 1 specialization, core specialization. So I told them this thing. So they asked me a few questions based about my quality and how much do I love interacting with people and what have I done previously. On the basis of that, they suggested me that I should go for marketing only. So that was all my interview experience. All in all, it was good. It was not very tough. I would not say it was on. It was basically the interview basically focused on your experiences, what you aspire to do, and how are you? What is your thinking process? So basically, it was all.
Okay, great. So the selection process also had a counseling round wherein you came to know that marketing is best for you.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
Great. So obviously you came from Ranchi and spent 2 years here. So what changes basically do you see in yourself after this MBA?
Yeah, I would say that earlier I was a kind of introverted person, like antisocial. I did not like to interact so much with people. I did not had many friends. I did not like going to parties and all. So I was a very self-confined person, if you say. So, and after moving to Pune for my PGDM degree, in MBA, what happens is you get a lot of group projects, teamwork, and this is all about that. Presentations, last time case studies, which you are not supposed to do individually. You are basically, I remember all the projects and all the presentations which we had to do, it was into a group only, basically 3 or 5. So if you are in a group, you have to take the lead, you have to talk to people, you have to prepare the presentation, and you always want to be better than the others who are also presenting the same thing. So one thing which happened with me was I became an extroverted person, talking to so much people. I made a lot of friends, which gave me confidence, very much confidence, that today I can talk to anybody, like anyone. It does not scare me like it used to do earlier. It does not happen to me now. And as, other than that, time management is the main thing which I learned. Because our college hours were long, as it is in corporate, we are going on a corporate journey. So our B school prepared us for the corporate journey very well. The class hours were long. So you have to manage your classes, your presentations, your other things, and also in the same time. So, and as you start going to college, you learn to manage those things. So these are the few changes which happened in me, and that is for very good.
Wow, nice. So now you can be a good salesperson or a marketeer.
Yeah, I'm very confident about that.
Great. So that's it from my side. Thank you very much, Vaishali, for sharing your scoop. And we wish you luck for your future endeavors.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye-bye.